going on, guys? Ahmed back with another video. Today, I got to do a rant. There's something I've been seeing on Instagram, conversations on hip-hop media outlets, and conversations with my friends, and now even Funk Flex, who I was, and to a certain extent am still a fan of, has even thrown his hat into the ring on this conversation. And you all read the title. This is basically the influx of hate, not really hate, but I would say dismissal of Griselda. And I will be making the case on why not only should Griselda be taken, be not be dismissed, but they should be taken serious as a heart attack. They should be taken as threats to the crown of New York. And most importantly, they should be taken seriously as integral aspects of New York hip hop. So who are Griselda? Griselda is a rap collective that is comprised of a lot of different people. But for this conversation, we're going to be talking about the three primary members: Westside Gunn, Conway the Machine, and Benny the Butcher. Going back and doing my research, they seem to hit everybody's radar around 2017, 2018. And when I mean everybody, I mean in terms of critical acclaim and in terms of music reviewers. They seem to hit that radar in around 2017, 2018. The first record that I hear a lot of people talk about their introduction to Griselda was Tana Talk 3 by Benny the Butcher. And from there, it's just kind of been an up and up slope for them. They've dropped plenty of mixtapes, plenty of albums, and they have been receiving high praise critically for years now, but still remained as underground artists. However, in recent years, they have finally broken into almost mainstream. I think I'm going to call it an up and coming phase because I think there's the underground and then there's the mainstream. And I think a lot of people are in between where they're not underground anymore, but they're definitely not mainstream either. And I think I want to call that up and coming. So they're definitely at this point in the up and coming, largely in part due to the Dreamville feature that they have been getting for Benny the Butcher. He dropped Tana Talk 4 this year, incredible album, and he had the standout single with J. Cole, where it sparked a lot of conversation and really has people talking about J. Cole's pen game. But also, as a hit song, really blew up and put Benny on the map from a commercial standpoint, as I'm pretty sure this is his biggest song to date. And Conway actually came out last year with a really big song called Scatterbrained, featuring JID, like I said, Dreamville, and Ludacris. And so they've been having this recent rise in commercial success, and it's been great to watch. However, it's not all been peaches and rainbows. It's been a really long journey for them, and they talk about that in interviews, about how long of a journey it was to reach any modicum of commercial success.
I can agree with that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And maybe now they are catching on and shit, but that's just one of the obstacles we had to overcome being right. From Buffalo, is that we had to go extra hard. We had to drop 12 projects in a year and shit just to, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Be in the conversation.
Keep up to other guys who had to drop one project.
Yeah, work extra hard.
Yeah, we had to work 10 times as hard as...
Right.
And we wouldn't have had to if we were from a borough or from like a, you know, Atlanta or LA or Houston or somewhere like a big known popular city. I could be wrong, but I just feel like we wouldn't have had to do what we had to do to get here.
Because on paper, they had all the cosigns. They had decent labels, although the labels, I don't think, were right for them or were a good fit for them. And they also didn't get pushed in the way that I believe that they should. But they had plenty of discographies, plenty of songs that could have gone viral or could have been played on the radio, but for some reason or the other, just weren't able to fully break into the mainstream. And a lot of people have been responding to their frustration with their difficulties up and coming. And people have been lobbying all kinds of attacks that we will get into in just a second. But first, where is the hate coming from? Specifically, the two main things that made me really want to do this video was the video I saw from a basketball commentator named Shannon Sharp, where he was talking about, I ain't never heard of these niggas, Buffalo niggas, they don't deserve respect, And Funk Flex, who sort of clapped back to Conway, suggesting that Flex stopped him from succeeding because Flex doesn't like their music. So let's get into it. The first main critique that I hear often about Griselda is not even about their music. To me, that's how you always know somebody's music fire, by the way, y'all. If somebody's first critique of somebody is not their music, that's how you know the music is gas. But the first critique I heard was not even of their music, but it was the fact that they were from Buffalo and that they're not from the city. And so they can't be King of New York because King of New York is King of New York City. And so they don't deserve to be in these conversations. They don't deserve exposure because they're not from the Big Apple. They're not from the bussin' places. And this is kind of stupid for two reasons. One is just prejudice for no reason. Like, if somebody outside of Georgia was killing it, I don't feel like Atlanta niggas would be like, oh, well, you can't do it. Like, and we see different people from different parts of Los Angeles come through and kill it all the time, from Compton to Long Beach to the Bay Area. Like, so it just seemed kind of prejudicial, but I do get it. For the longest, as long as we know, New York rap has been completely dominated by the boroughs. And while Staten Island had a run with the Wu-Tang Clan, it was a run. And technically Staten Island is still a borough, a racist borough, but a borough nonetheless. And so, okay, valid. Again, still a bit just prejudicial for no reason, but I can understand why some people might feel this way. The other problem with this point, though, is that at the end of the day, we need them. And I may talk about this in a different video when I can do a proper, thorough, you know, deep dive into this, but New York hip hop is not what it once was. It's not from a numbers perspective, it's not the biggest and most lucrative state anymore. And I don't even think it's third. I don't even know if it's third, to be honest, because LA is killing it. Chicago is killing it commercially, right? I mean, I'm not speaking to the quality of music. I'm just speaking commercially. And at the end of the day, we need as many people as we can get, from both inside and out, from people like 50 Cent, who literally destroyed New York hip hop from the inside, which again, I will make a separate video really crystallizing what I mean when I say 50 Cent destroyed New York hip hop, versus forces on the outside, such as distribution deals and labels not favoring New York, and just trends moving in different directions, you know, in moving away from gangster rap. New York has died down. The fact that the most popular male out of New York is A Boogie, who I love A Boogie and I think he's incredible, but his last album only did 111K. And while that's amazing, consider the fact that a mediocre Dirk album did 128K and a great, not amazing, not perfect, but just a great Lil Baby album, In My Turn, did almost 200K, right? Even Jack Harlow, with a bad album, did 135. And this is not to say that, you know, sales are the end-all, be-all, but when we're talking about the most dominating force in a state, commercially, we're not there yet. We've fallen behind. And I think that the more rappers that we have that are really killing it, and the more rappers who we have that can consistently deliver quality music, the better, right? The more rappers we have, the more competition there is. The more competition there is to be the greatest, the more harder different artists are going to push to be great. And I'm telling you, Griselda is a powerful force. So when you have a force like that, that's that competitive, and you mix them in with the rest of the New York people, it's spooky. It is intense. And the competition will, of course, rise and grow. We'll grow the rap scene. So from a, I think this whole It's from Buffalo argument, not only is it just inherently prejudicial, it's also not productive, because we actively benefit from Griselda. The other thing I hear a lot is, well, they're not popping, or we don't care because they're just lyrical old niggas and their music can't be played in the club. And this makes a little bit of sense when you like look at it at like super hardcore face value. But when you dig a little bit deeper, this doesn't really line up at all. I guess a better way to say that would be that, you know, Griselda isn't the current sound of New York. But even so, that doesn't really line up at all. Let me break this down. So first of all, what kind of music does Griselda make? And I will say from this moment on, if you hate lyrical rap, if you have a disdain for lyrical rap, you could bounce. Don't unsubscribe. I'm just saying from this video. Because if you hate lyrical rap just for it being lyrical rap, you're not going to like Griselda. And that's fine. That's honestly perfectly fine. Go listen to Cardi. Go listen to Uzi. Go listen to Boogie. Go listen to, you know what I'm saying? That's fine. I ain't got no problem with that. Right. But if you're one of those people who likes lyrical rap but doesn't want it to be boring, stick around. So in terms of stylistically, I hate to do this, but the only group that I can compare them to, because I know the most about this group, is the Migos. Unfortunately, I don't know enough about NWA or the Fugees or a Tribe Called Quest to really properly do this comparison justice. But let's break this down right quick. Let's compare the Migos to Griselda. So let's do this. Let's match it up, right? I would say that Benny the Butcher is the takeoff of the group, right? Not the most versatile of all time, and can sometimes get repetitive, but lyrically and punchline for punchline, he is the strongest. And unlike Takeoff, he can out-rap pretty much anybody in New York right now, aside from maybe Joey Badass. Maybe he's out-rapping every young nigga from New York right now. And so he's able, so for those who love to hear those bars, that's him, right? That's your man. Conway the Machine is more like the Offset of the group for me, right? Where he's not always gonna have the craziest, like complex or whatever punchlines, but he is the most versatile and he's got the craziest cadence, And when I mean versatile, I mean in subject matter, right? You look at Offset's solo album and you see that he's talking about so many different things, so many different parts of his life. That's what you're gonna get on a Conway album. He's talking about so many different parts of his life and the cadence is bananas. Also a weird similarity that I noticed another similarity is that Offset, like Conway, they both kind of go crazy on the feature game. I feel like as both Offset and Cardi just have such extravagant features, like not for no reason, because it's honestly, it's incredible, but it's like, I didn't even know that code. Like, you said Offset and Travis Scott, and that shit works? You said Conway and Jill Scott, like, and that lines up? Like, that's crazy. And then West Side Gun is Quavo, the originator, the glue of the group, but also from a musical perspective, doesn't stand, maybe doesn't always stand out on his own, and can get, you know, may feel kind of awkward on his own, but when you stick him, and this is all my opinion, by the way, when you stick him in the group and when he's making songs with the group, he is the glue that makes the song come to life, right? He is the hype. He is the energy. He is the excitement that makes the Griselda songs, the collective Griselda song, truly come to life in very exciting ways, right? From his high-pitched voice to his ad-libs to just his energy on a song.
That's why the door on my bedroom thick as a vault.
Hey, yo, nigga. No bricks in the off-white Ramoa. The shit see-through, we rockin' for the culture. Bodies on each pole, keep acting like you know us.
He is the person who really, the song structure and the overall listenability, West Side Gun is who brings that. In the same way that Quavo brings that for the Migos with his auto-tune choruses and his generally fun bars and his sort of witty flows, but mainly the voice and the auto-tune. Of course, the difference between Migos and Griselda is that Griselda is less of a flexing trap rap group and more of a lyrical street rap group with a heavy emphasis on their drug dealings and their tragedies in their life. And the reason I say all of this is because for those who enjoy lyrical rap but don't want it to be boring, I feel you. I do. I actually can't stand when lyrical rap gets boring. I can't listen to it. It's why I love J. Cole, because J. Cole says that there's you can be lyrical without being boring. That's why I love Jid. Same thing. You can be lyrical without being boring. But that's also why I love Griselda, because with their unique things that they bring to a record, along with Alchemist production, Alchemist, if you don't know, is an incredible producer, brings extremely layered and complex beats to everything that really just do so much world building and so much environment creation in terms of really bringing you into the position that the guys are in. And he is the main producer for all three of the guys on their solo work and on their collab work. Just absolutely incredible. Or Uncle Al, as they call it. When you see them when you see them come together, and when you watch it in motion, it's more than just random lyrical guys spitting. It is poetry, but it is a world that you're being led into, right? It is things and experiences that you can resonate with, especially growing up in a not so nice neighborhood, is something I can resonate with, right? And it is exciting adventures and storytellings and quotables that you can get behind, right? It's not just complex to be complex. It's quotables that you can resonate with, that you can sing, that you can enjoy, and that you can feel in your heart. And to the complaint about, oh, it's not club music, and so that's why it's not blowing up, that would assume that the only people to get respect in New York are people who make club music, and that doesn't add up at all. Chef G and Sleepy Hollow do not make club music. Like, they don't. Like, no Suburbans is like the most maybe club anthem you could play. But beyond that, they just don't really make club music. But it's okay, because they're still respected and their craft is still valued. Joey Badass does not make club music, but that's okay because his respect is still valued and appreciated. Even A Boogie, the biggest person in New York, for the most part, doesn't make club records. Sure, he has a couple club records on each album here and there, but the bulk of his discography isn't club records. And then on the flip side, somebody like a French Montana, where the bulk of his discography is an attempt to make club records, he doesn't get the most respect. And so that leaves us with the idea that club records aren't necessary. If you can provide service in other ways, if you can be great in other ways, club records shouldn't be the only way to receive some kind of respect or appreciation from New York hip hop. And the thing I think that's most toxic about that mindset is that it makes us as fans only cued in to one sound. It makes us only able to appreciate one kind of music. And that's the worst thing you can possibly have for a state. That's how stuff can get stale. That's how stuff gets boring. And we know this because when we hear people outside of New York talk about New York music, we hear them say, I like drill, but that shit got boring. That's what we hear. And so I think that Griselda is providing much needed competition. It is providing much needed diversity. And it is a group of rappers that has found a way to create incredible, critically acclaimed music that can also resonate with the everyman. And that's dope, and that deserves to be respected. So yeah, that's everything on Griselda. Those are just the reasons why I feel like they deserve respect in hip hop, and why I think they deserve respect and a conversation in the top spot in New York. Hopefully you all enjoyed this video. I'm actually gonna put my Instagram for this video down in the comments, and if y'all want to debate me, if y'all want to talk to me about this this idea or this anything I've said in this video, let's do it. I'm gonna put my Instagram down there. You all can DM me, and so I don't have comments right now because I don't have enough subscribers, which please subscribe. I need the subs, I need the likes, all of that. But let me know what you all think about this video, and let me know what y'all think about the style of video. I think I still kind of a little bit too long and too long-winded in my speech or whatever, but I feel like this for me had a little bit more structure, and I think I like this style of talking to you all with things and points to rattle off. So yeah, hope you all have a good day. Peace, y'all.